Hey guys, it's Dan Korneff, and I want to walk you through the new Amplified Instrument Processor update. If you're already familiar with this plugin, you can see we gave it a little bit of a facelift, and we've added an input meter to the frequency-dependent reduction, as well as adjust the frequency to go all the way up to 20K. So now you can use this as a de-esser if you would like. If you're not familiar with this plugin, this is a channel strip that I created that contains all the processes I use while I'm mixing guitars. And although it was originally made for guitars, you can use it on anything. We have a four-band EQ based on a tube German equalizer circuit, high-pass, low-pass filter, analog channel variance, which will change the way that these EQ curves react. There's some Korneff Audio proprietary signal processing with a few extra controls on the back. We have our phase meter, stereo widener, a VCA compressor, and my favorite control, the insufferable mid-range filter. On the back, we have some extra controls for each of these features. So as part of the equalizer, we have a frequency-dependent reduction, which is a dynamic EQ that we can use to tame down low-end chugs on a guitar, or now we can use it as a de-esser on a vocal. There's a graphical view that's going to show us the frequency response curves of our equalizer, and there is a knob that can switch the curve between modern and vintage, a button to invert the EQ curve. This is extra helpful for finding frequencies that you don't like, boosting them a lot on the front, come back here, toggling this button, getting rid of them. There's a gain scale for the EQ, so you can accentuate or dial back your curves. And there is a knob here that controls the age of the circuit, which means new is going to be a little cleaner, and the more you dial it to the old side, you'll see it gets a little more ripple and artifacts in the signal. Down here, we have a circuit board for the VCA compressor that has a couple controls. We have a distortion null trimmer, which we can use to make the compressor either clean or a bit dirty. And there's a VCA symmetry control down here, which will affect how closely the left and right channels are processed. And on the right here, we have our controls for the proprietary signal processing, which you turn on from the front here, and you have three different shapes, and also the transient response of each of those can be adjusted from a bright signal to a dark signal. Right down the middle here, we have our zoom factor. We have GPU acceleration that allows your computer to use hardware to process the graphics, which can make things run a lot smoother depending on what system you're on. And a button to turn on oversampling, and our wet and dry blend, so you can use this as a parallel processor. The utility panel at the bottom has a tooltip button, so you can see what each of the controls do. We have our onboard manual, so if you ever get lost, just come in here and you can see what everything does. There's an A, B compare button, and a copy A to B, and an undo and redo system. Down here, we have our preset browser. You click the tape here to open it up. We've slightly revamped this system. So now we have some new visuals. We have a little bio links to the creator's socials, which is me. And we also have our input level and output level meters and a trim for the input and output. The info button's gonna open up a panel that will tell you about the plugin, including the product name, the version number, the build date, and some credits. And also tells you who our wonderful beta testers are. And it has links to all of our socials just in case you need to get in contact with us. And my favorite is the insufferable mid-range filter. Now I designed this to help quickly target and remove annoying frequencies from any signal. Just simply turn it on, hit the listen button, and now you can scroll through and find the frequency, how many octaves you'd like to affect of that frequency, turn off the listen button, and then apply how much reduction you'd like. By carving out these frequencies, sometimes makes the signal a little dull, so we've added a high frequency compensation knob to help bring the signal back to life. And that's it. That's what this guy does. Go check out the update and tell us what you think.